Hi artists, this is Ms. Fung from Gatewood and Tanglin. Today we're going to talk about outsider art. Here are the learning targets for this project. ICAN study the Art Brut movement. ICAN explore non-traditional art making materials. ICAN create an original artwork inspired by the principles of the Art Brut movement. Art Brut. Jean Dubuffet was a French artist. He was born in 1901 and died in 1985. He was the founder of the Art Brut movement. Otherwise known as raw art or outsider art, he coined this term as a way to categorize the artwork that he loved, made by introverted, isolated, and exceptionally imaginative artists. It was a reaction to refined art and celebrated unrestrained use of unusual materials and obsessive repetition of design and pattern. Outsider artists often dealt with emotional struggles and created art as an outwards path to find inner peace. Here's the story of an outsider artist. Scotty Wilson was born in Glasgow, Scotland in 1888. He enlisted with the Scottish Rifles and fought in the Great War. Afterwards, he emigrated to Toronto in Canada, where he opened a secondhand shop. At age 44, Wilson started to doodle on his countertop with one of the used fountain pens that was for sale. He had an epiphany and said of the experience, "I'm listening to classical music one day, Mendelssohn, when all of a sudden I dipped the bulldog pen into the bottle of ink and started drawing. Doodling, I suppose you'd call it, on the cardboard tabletop. I don't know why, I just did. In a couple of days, I worked almost ceaselessly. The whole of the tabletop was covered with little faces and designs. The pen seemed to make me draw, and the images, the faces and designs, just flowed out. I couldn't stop. I've never stopped since that day." This artwork is called The Tree of Life. It was painted in 1928 by a French artist named Séraphine Louis. This French artist created many floral and tree-related paintings. She was inspired by the feeling of peace she got when looking at stained glass windows. She used oil paint infused with wax and other mystery ingredients that she never revealed, and is known for her repetition of petals and leaves. Her work is seen as a frenzied attempt to show life's beauty. She spent much of her life battling mental illness. Creating your own outsider art. Your artwork should include repetitive design and patterns. That means more than once, each design and pattern should show up many times. At least one unconventional art making supply. That could be your materials that you apply to the surface itself, or the applicator that you use to apply the material. Your artwork should deal with the theme of finding peace. This could be inner peace, such as emotional well-being. It could be world peace, such as society's ending conflict. It could be physical peace, such as stillness and calm, or any other type of piece that you decide fits the theme. There is no size requirement. That depends on the surface you choose. Here are some unconventional materials you might think of using. Artists who fit in the Art Brut category rarely use typical art making materials that you might find in a store. More frequently, they created marks on their work with whatever they had nearby. Take a look at the pictures. Imagine how you might use these materials to add color, texture, pattern, and design to your artwork. For example, at the top, you see some charcoal. Maybe you have a fire pit in your yard and you can go grab some charcoal and draw with it, much like you would draw with the charcoal in school. You can boil onion skins to create a type of paint. Maybe you find some flower petals and you can rub those on your paper to get some of the color off onto your page. You could be like Scotty Wilson and you could make a drawing out of a pen. All right, so that's just finding material that is nearby. Below the pen, you'll see some tea, much like the onion skins. If you boil it, it creates a darker color. You can also use coffee. Next to that, we have some food coloring. You could use food coloring instead of paints. And over on the other side, we have mud and sand. Many artists in the Art Brut or outsider art category use materials like mud and sand to add texture and a dark, muddy color to their work. Alternative surfaces. An outsider artist may not have access or the desire to create art on the usual surfaces that we think of when creating art. In addition to the materials on this page, what other surfaces could you find to create art on? Maybe you're going to make art on newspaper or fabric, or a little scrap of wood. Maybe a paper bag is your canvas, or some cardboard, or even the sidewalk outside on a nice day. No paintbrush? No problem. Once you've found a material to use and a surface to apply the material to, then you need to find something to apply it with. Can you think of any other applicators you might use to create art if you didn't have a paintbrush? Maybe you're going to spread some paint with a feather. Maybe you're going to put charcoal on your fingers and make fingerprints with it. Maybe you're going to spread some coffee with grasses or some type of leaf you find outside. Maybe you're going to spread some mud with a popsicle stick or the end of an eraser. Think about making repetitive marks on your page and using the theme of peace, create an artwork, and upload it to Seesaw.